Hello everybody. Today I'm going to go through our next Grace Darling topic lesson. And in this lesson, we are going to be looking at how should Grace Darling be remembered? Because we still think of her today, we're still studying her today, and she was alive 200 years ago. So let's have a think about it. What qualities did Grace Darling have? Now have a think a minute about what she did, why we remember her because of her rescue. Now, what kind of person would she need to be to have done that rescue? You could pause the video now if you like and have a little think and see if you come up with the same sorts of things that I have. Well done. So let's have a look what I've got underneath my lifeboats. So the first one that I thought of was perseverance. Now imagine if you were Grace and you went out on that stormy night. It was very rough and noisy and wet and windy and dark. And you had to row that wooden rowing boat all by yourself while her father got people into the boat. She had to keep rowing for a long time, which would have been really tough going, especially in those waves. She would have to have been very strong. So she really had to persevere to rescue those people. Let's have a look what's under the next one. We have got courage. Now, courage is another word for being brave, bravery. So she had to have a lot of courage and be very brave to have gone out of her cozy lifeboat, got out of bed, gone into that terrible storm in the dark to rescue those survivors from the ship. Now, our next one is responsibility. Now, she took responsibility for all those people that were clinging to the rock. She took responsibility to rescue them herself. And the next one is kindness. Now, she would have had to have been a very kind person to help others. And linked to kindness, I've also got compassion and empathy, which are the same kind of thing, and a bit like kindness. She had to imagine how terrible it would have been, how those people would have been feeling, clinging to that rock. They've just been shipwrecked in the middle of the night. They must have been feeling so worried. And so she showed compassion and empathy in order to go out and carry out her rescue. And all of these values that we've got written here are some of our school values. So then we say, well, Grace was a great person. She did a wonderful thing. But how could we be more like Grace? Well, if we look at the qualities we've just spoken about, we can have a look. So let me look at perseverance and I'll move this picture of Grace out of the way. Well, we talk about perseverance in school, don't we? Sometimes we do work that we find a bit tricky or something that we're not quite as interested in as other things, but we still have to do them because we need to know how to do them. And so we need to persevere with them. So we can persevere like Grace did at school, and also in the rest of our lives at home, we might have some hobbies. You might have a hobby that you like doing, or any activity that you want to do, something you really want to do that you might not know how to do at the beginning, or it might be hard and you have to be patient and practice and persevere with it in order to get better. Now let's look at kindness. What can we do to be more like Grace with kindness. Now, she showed kindness towards the survivors, so we can show kindness towards others, our family, our friends, people, anyone that we come into contact with, we can show kindness to them. Courage. Now, sometimes it's very hard to show courage and to be brave, particularly if we're upset or worried about something. But it's something just to bear in mind. Try and be brave. Responsibility. Now, we can show responsibility at school. We can show responsibility for our work. If you make sure that you're doing what you need to do and you're doing your absolute best, that is showing responsibility. Or maybe if you suddenly decide, oh, this classroom is in a mess, why don't I go and tidy it up? That is showing that you've noticed that there's a problem and you've taken responsibility for it and you've sorted it out. And you can do the same at home. You could take responsibility for getting yourself out of bed, getting yourself dressed, getting yourself washed, all of those things, or helping out around the house, doing some hoovering, any of those things. I'm sure your mums and dads would really love that too. And compassion, let's see, how can we be compassionate? Well, if we show compassion and empathy towards others, to anyone we meet, whether that's somebody in our family or one of our friends or anyone else at school, we understand that if we see somebody that's maybe feeling a bit sad, we can see that they're sad and we can find out why and understand how they feel. So that are a few ways of how we can be more like Grace Darling. Now, Grace Darling was given a silver medal for her bravery. She had a bravery medal, and that was given to her, and I've underlined it here, by the National Institution for the Preservation of a Life from Shipwreck. That's a bit of a mouthful, isn't it? Now, that is an institution which was around when Grace was alive. And so, as you can see, they save lives from people that have been shipwrecked in the sea. Now, later on, after Grace's rescue, this institution became the Royal National Lifeboat Institution, or the RNLI. That's what the letters stand for, RNLI. Now, I'm sure all of you know what the RNLI is because we had a talk from somebody at the RNLI last week, didn't we? And this here is a picture of the medal she was given. So this bit here, that's one side of it. I think that's the back. And then if you turn it over to the front, this is the front of it. And can you see it's got Grace Darling written on it? She's got her name on it and the year that she did her rescue, 1838. That must have made her feel very proud of herself. So, the RNLI. Now, you probably might have seen one of these lifeboats at some time, even either in the flesh or when you're on holiday or on TV maybe or in a book. So the RNLI still rescues people who are in trouble at sea. And their crews, that's all the people who go out on the boats, and the lifeguards that you see on the beach who usually wear red and yellow. Now, all of these people are volunteers. You see, I've underlined it here. Do you know what volunteer means? Well, a volunteer is a person who offers to work or help out without being paid. So all the people that you see on the beach, the lifeguards, and all the people that go out in the lifeboats for the RNLI, that's not actually their job. They don't get paid to do that. They volunteer to do this in their own time. And some of them might get called out in the middle of the night if there is a rescue that needs happening. They'll have an emergency alarm to all of the people who volunteered to be a crew, and they'll have to jump out of bed, get down to the lifeboat station and get in their boat as soon as possible so they can go and rescue those people. Now, let's have a think about remembering Grace, darling. Now, all these pictures here are ways that Grace was celebrated at the time when she was alive. So let's have a look at what we've got here. Now this, after she died, this is a monument that was built to remember her. It's very fancy and ornate, and that's all carved out of stone. And then here we have a mug with, as you can see here, a picture of her. We've got a plate or a tray. There's a picture of Grace in the middle and a picture of her and her father in the rowing boat on one side. And I think that's a picture of the, all the survivors in the rowing boat on the other side. We've even got a stained glass window. So that's a glass window that's made out of coloured glass, which has got her portrait in the middle. And can you believe, look at this one. There's even a box of chocolates was made by Cadbury's. It says Cadbury's Grace Darling chocolates with a picture of her. So at the time, they obviously thought a lot of her and thought she was an amazing woman. And so they did lots of things to celebrate her rescue. But even now, 200 years later, there are still things that we are doing to remember Grace Darling and celebrate her. Apart from learning about her in school, down here we've got the Grace Darling Museum. Now, this Grace Darling Museum is not far from the lighthouse where she lived and where she did her rescue. And this is a whole museum just on Grace Darling. So that's pretty special, isn't it? And now here, this is a school. And this building of the school, you can't quite read it there, but it's called the Grace Darling Building. And over here, of course, one of the RNLI lifeboats. And this lifeboat has been named after her, Grace Darling, it says on the side there. So we've got a couple of activities for you to do. The first one is, can you create a poster for the RNLI asking for volunteers? Because if not enough people volunteer, they won't have enough crew to man the lifeboats and go out and rescue people. So it's really important that they have enough volunteers to do the job of saving people. So this poster, this is an example of a poster here. And it says, can you volunteer for the RNLI? And this is a poster made by Dart Lifeboat Station. There are lots of lifeboat stations all around the United Kingdom, and each one will need its volunteers. So this one is a special poster done by Dart Lifeboat Station. Now, I've also put a picture of the RNLI flag here, because you might want to include it on your poster. And that shows you what it looks like. And you can see it just down here at the bottom. Now you don't have to put that on there, but if you do, you could do it any size you like, wherever you like, but at least you can see what it looks like. Now the next task is, Grace Darling won a medal for bravery during the rescue. Can you create a medal for Grace Darling? So you could do a lovely picture designing it and you could make it. And again, if you put all these lovely photos of your work on Dojo, I really want to see what you've been doing, what your posters look like, what your medals look like. And then we will choose some to put on our celebration at the end of the day.